Hey everyone, it's day two of my shoulder surgery rehab and I am now back at home obviously, and it's been okay. Yesterday was pretty tough. The first day, not gonna lie, it was pretty sore, but I've got my meds on track now. So if I sound a little bit arious, because I'm on some painkillers, but we've got that down pat now, so it should sort of keep giving me some relief. I've also got the ice on, that is essential. I've just got a little ice pack, an old ice pack that I had that's wrapped in a little wrap. So I'll just pop that on there. And I do that about 20, 30 minutes every hour or so at the moment, just to try and keep it cooled down, and just gives you that little bit of relief there on top of the medication, which is nice. So, and in my sling, you've probably seen that from the picture, my full-on Robocop brace with my little squeezy ball that I need to squeeze. And I've got a whole range of exercises for the first 2 weeks. So from 0 to 2 weeks, it's all at home stuff. So there's no physio going on. I won't be going to the clinic. And the exercise that I do are a range of movement things that I either get my family to help me with, or and I can do some myself. So I'll show you them tomorrow. But first today, I'm going to post up all those videos now of the surgery. So be warned, if you're not into gore, then you may not want to look at those, but they're really, really interesting. And it has certainly been an experience watching yourself get surgery. That's a bizarre experience. So we were very lucky that we had my colleague Claire was allowed into the theatre to video that. And Simon Tan and Scott Burne have been amazing at educating us through that. So when you watch those videos, you'll see Simon Tan explain what he's doing. You'll be able to see my shoulder and the scope video, which is really, really cool. So it gives you a really good idea on what goes on for rotator cuff surgery. And it's really good for me to know, okay, that's what's happened to my shoulder. So when I have future patients, I know what they go through in theatre, what goes on there, and also what they need to do to try and repair the problem, but also why they're in pain afterwards and how to manage that. So it's as much as it's, you know, it's a really big process to go through, it's going to be a really good thing for me myself to go through to help patients in the future. So I'm also doing this for you guys who are physios, to try and help you guys understand what goes on and try and improve our rehab that we give our clients who've had these sort of problems. So in a nutshell, my operation now, I'll put this, you'll see it in the description on my post, but you'll see the portals there. Got a bit of a bleed on that one, but there's a lot of portals going on here because there's a lot of things that went done. It was a rotator cuff repair, so I had my supraspinatus. So Simon Tan has pulled back my supraspinatus and prepared the footprint and anchored that back on. He's also done a bursectomy because I had acute bursitis in there. They've been going on for a year. And he's done an acromioplasty underneath the acromion. And he's also tendonized the bicep. Now, the reason for that was I had a labral tear in there as well. But when he went in, the actual bicep tendon that was coming up was frayed to pieces. So it was almost like a horse's tail. It was that bad. So that bicep tendon was almost about to snap anyway. So what they've done is they've rescued that and at a point marked it and screwed that tendon into the bone and above the groove there, and then snipped off the tendon to the labrum. So that's freed that up, so it doesn't tug on that anymore. So I've got a better chance of improving that. So as I said, the surgery videos are coming up next. You'll see them posted up, and my rehab, I will show you what I'm doing in day three. See you then.